today. We are going to be doing Season 2, Episode 5, Autumn Splendor. So lots of colors happening in this one. I'll have to make sure I pay attention to what's going on. Let's see. Just trying to make sure that my feed is working properly. So sorry for the distraction. Here to get this up and running. Listen to some cat. Make it quiet. There, and I'm going to recycle this. It should be up and running. Sorry for the delay, folks. Okay, cool. So, let's see. Joy painting. We're looking at... here's the end result that he is professing. And... let's see what we got going on. I'll kick this up to... So as usual, I come in, and since I need to be able to get a color reference, I come in here, and I'll grab a screenshot real quick, put this down to Photoshop, go on to here, we'll zoom in real fast, we'll grab this, and we'll grab this, we'll come back to here, make a new layer, I'm going to just autofill canvas color that he's got in his in the video. And then a new layer on top of that, switch out to this blue that he's using. Let's verify that we're working on a normal canvas. It needs to be pulled back for a second here with the camera so we can see what we're looking at. I suspect it's a horizontal wide. There. It's at four, it's foreshortened. So it's probably a standard 18x24. So we'll just assume it is and work on it from there. If my ratios end up being different from his, then so what? It's about the skills, not about the specifics. So we're just gonna drobble that in. Oh wow, he's really just letting it in lightly, isn't he? That's awesome. Here, we're going to remove spacing. So, it's going to come in here with this cloud tool that I built. It's 80% strength smudge brush. Just laying these little doobly-doos here. You can see all this fun stuff just working in, like little cloud bits. We're not really emphasizing anything too specifically because he's really de-emphasizing how the sky is looking in this particular picture. Probably because there's a whole bunch of color happening in the trees themselves. Doesn't really need to focus on that. But there it is. So that's our sky. Super simple. Blur. Come in with a Gaussian blur to soften up the brush strokes a little bit. Make them a little less pointy. Hourglass means we'll take a sip. And we'll hit save. Grab another sip. There we go. I think that's pretty much all he has going on for the sky in this particular episode. Let's just go back in here and see what he's got going on. There we go. That's a good screenshot. No, I didn't ask you to do that. Pack it up. Thank you. I'm going to do this. Thank you. Just wanted to see where we're at with this here. It's a little bit over halfway. So I'm going to be somewhere down around there. Let's just come in here and take a look at what we got going on with these colors. So Yeah, it's barely into the red a bit. And that pushes it, so it starts off darker up here, and then it fades, and the green starts to kick in a bit more down here. Over here we're looking. Green starts to get emphasized as he pushes down the page. Let's see if I can find a decent color sample of that. That's interesting. Alright, that'll be an interesting fade. So let's see. Let's see what I can do. See all those little brush strokes? All these little brush strokes where he's got all this negative space inside of the space here. This really, obviously, it just naturally looks like foliage with the spacing that goes on with it. So let's play a bit. Try to keep that in mind while we're working on what we're working on. Let's see, what kind of brush do we want to use for this? I got all sorts of messy brushes here that I can play with. I think I'm going to play with, we'll go with this brush initially. These are all brushes that I created to help assimilate these scatter effects that he works with. So we're gonna, and that feels pretty good. I'm gonna start there. I'm gonna take down the size so that we can create more edge. An eraser. This whole technique is about adding and subtracting from what it is that you're putting into the space. So I'm adding paint in, and then with the Photoshop, for me to be able to simulate these scattery effects, I want to make sure that I'm adding and then I want to subtract. So, tools are still a work in progress. That's about halfway mark is about where he's at. Here, and here. I don't want to spend too much time thinking about it, but it needs to be thought about. I can tap stuff in pretty well, like as he does with the randomization. I just want to make sure that I'm... as I said before, the randomization that we generate is a little more thought goes into it than just tapping it down and walking away. We have to the brushes themselves don't have the same flexibility that a hand brush does. You can just automatically change the angles of the wrist and the pressure that you're using. It's uniform. It's always going to be this shape. So we have to utilize tools to help simulate that same scattered randomization. So I've got a base there. I'm going to add an additional layer and use this other color down that he was using, this green, to come in and blend in with that work so that we get something somewhat close to what he was doing. See, I've got these cool little effects coming in here as well that end up looking pretty similar to what it was that he was doing right here. Take this claw and turn it sideways. Take down the opacity, the eraser down to 20 some odd percent. So I can tap at this. Everything he does is stippling, if you're familiar with different terms of art. He is laying in paint by tapping it. I mean, all he ever talks about is tapping, but tapping is stippling. So we can also stipple in Photoshop. So if we have tools that look like what his end results look like on canvas, then we are effectively producing the same results that he is, which is the whole point of these exercises that I've done, and building the brush set that I have, and running through these paintings to see that we're able to simulate what he's producing. So let's come back over here and take a look. Oh, he's just laying that mess in, isn't he? I'm gonna have to switch up the brush. Oh, perfect. Okay, so I'm going to get a new color reference. Like I said, I don't see the colors, so I have to reference them often to make sure that I'm doing them right. So I mean, if you look, I've got all the colors over here in this palette. I built this when when I first started this, but I quickly realized that if I try to, when you're colorblind, you can't just mix the colors. They just don't work right. But, you know, y'all playing at home, I'll provide this. As soon as I get all this Patreon stuff figured out, like I keep threatening, I'll have all these things up for you to take advantage of and play with yourself if you're interested in doing that. And obviously you're watching, I'll have the brush sets available that I'm using to create these effects. So if that's something you guys are interested in, then awesome, I'm happy to provide. So let's see, let's check our colors here as well. Here, that green I was looking at before. Let's go down here and see if there's something different going on. No, not really. Nothing. Yeah, it looks like he's pretty much going with the same mess as he was. So that's what I'll do. So yeah, he's got a lot going on in here. See, he's got this shape here. He's got these shapes here. He's got this. So he's coming in, he's laying down paint, and it fades out. And he comes in here and blazing paint and it fades out. Then he'll reload his brush and come back in, and he'll tap in here, but he's loading less paint on it. So initially, he has a whole bunch of paint up here for the contrast of the sky. And then as he fades down the page, he's picking up less paint as he goes, so he taps in over here, and then he reloads a little bit, and he taps in over here. So these gaps he's creating in the foliage is what creates the separation, this depth here, 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 and then down here. So that's a neat trick. We're gonna wanna dump it in around here and then come down. So like I said, I'm not looking to duplicate his work, but I wanna pay attention to where he's at and what he's doing and why is he doing it to be able to simulate the effects with different tool set that's available in the Photoshop. So let's come back here. We're gonna plump up this brush a bit, give it a twist. We're on our dark, so let's spin that guy so he's facing up. The initial is like something like this. We'll come with our claw. See, this tool is great, but it has a lot of gets up to 100% opacity, 100% strength in your eraser. It's got a lot of these little wingdings out here that give the brush a lot more airiness than I really want it to have. So I just gotta pay attention to that, of that's what's going on. And of course I don't have the same type of fading effect that he does, so I'll just use an eraser and I can drop the opacity down to like 50%. So when I'm coming in here, I come in, keep that color, go back up to 100% up here in the corner, and then drop it down to 40% as I'm tapering down in here. Attention. He's got the other color that's working in. I'm coming with an eraser at about 30%. Give it a spin. I'm going to pull it short. There. And a larger brush so I can keep the texture interesting. Since I'm using a lower percentage brush, it's not laying in the dark immediately. I have to tap in place a few times for me to get that darkness. So this will naturally end up taking longer than what he does, but it has interesting effects. And I'm just obviously I've got a lot of different brushes. You know, I'll use the right brush to use. So there, that's not looking so bad. Come here and grab this. Make that my base for a little bit. So I'm sampling off of the color. I know the colors on the canvas are correct because they're the colors that I pulled from his work. So I can work inside this space and grab color samples off of the existing space and still feel confident that what I'm doing is accurate. I'll use a lower opacity brush and grab some of this again. Up the opacity to about 80% here. And come back through with the eraser brush, give it a spin. Just keep the angles fresh. So it's got a different feel to it. That's not so bad. Let's come in here and see what he's got going on here. And here. Not 100% for the eraser. Come back in. I'm gonna go there. Excuse me. And we're still working with that off green. Come over here. I'm going to tighten the brush down. That's too tight. And come here. All right, now I'm just laying in some texture. That up a bit, see where he's going with this stuff. There we go. Grab that. Ooh, interesting. Obviously, see, like, you know, obviously this is taking a lot longer than what he has, but again, it's just takes a little more effort and tool manipulation to be able to simulate the same effects, but the end results are pretty good. I'm always fiddling with these brushes to see if I can more accurately portray what it is I see happening on the screen. A really low strength, like 20% strength on the eraser, just so I can pull at these edge bits and tilt that up like that and come in here and poke at this here. Pan back a bit. Yeah, okay, it's different, but similar. So let's notice here that I've completely painted on my palette layer. So I gotta come in here and I gotta carve this thing out. There, I'm gonna take this and we'll drop it down here where it's supposed to be. Boop, a little bit of maintenance real quick here. Just see, it's just this is 4 inches, this is 18 tall, and 28 inches wide, and then I have the sidebar here, which is 4 inches. So when I finish the painting, I'm going to crop the 4 inches so it becomes 24 by 18. There you go. That's how that stuff happens. But so let's see, where are we at? We're almost out of time. Let's just see if we can get a little bit further down the road and see if there's anything else we can pick up real quick.
Oh, neat. Go-kart.
I can do that. And then we'll do that, and then we'll pretty much call it quit. So he's doing a lot of stuff with color in this episode. I really want to try to pay attention to everything that he's doing. There. Interesting. And he comes down here. Yeah, that's pretty good. That's good sampling there. Here. There, thank you.
Yeah.
It's the 24 by 18. And it's here, and it's here, and here. He's going down to... Here's the bottom. Here. And then here. Here. Okay, so that's almost a quarter. So it's important to pay attention to the ratio, so you guys going on. So here, it comes down to about here. Come in, build a new layer. Only at 20% on an eraser brush, so it doesn't fade everything out when it hits it. Again, if you go to 100%, it clears it out. But I'm only operating like around 20-30%. That's so I can get, since I'm laying color over other colors, it's going to be blending. So I'm going to try to pay attention to that. So when I'm erasing, I'm only except for over here on this edge, I want to trim. There you go. Otherwise, I'm keeping my eraser tool around 20%. So I'm going to switch it up. Switch out to this ground claw brush I've been using as an eraser. I'm going to use it for the brush now too. Yeah, too strong. Let's go down to 50%. Keep using the claw to erase. Thank you. Here. Yeah. Come on. And I'll take it down to 30%. That feels better. This one. Flip it over. Okay, we're almost there. I'm gonna just tap in some of this mass, and then we'll call it a day. And then we'll pick this up the next episode and get further down the road. So here. Done. There we go. Tapping along here. Doop. Okay. There we go. Da-da-da. To come in real quick here with the scatter brush that I use here. Just want to hit save, take a sip. I forgot to remove spacing, so I gotta wait on my hourglass here real quick. Take a sip when I get the hourglass. And thank you. Nope, took these. Almost there. You gotta be kidding me. Come on. Thank you. Come on. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. I'm taking this brush. It's really good at breaking up texture, so I'm gonna use it. I'm just gonna push up a little bit. Change the angle a little bit when I'm working on these contours. I'm coming back over to the foreground, so I'm gonna straighten up the angles a bit again. Here. This helps break up the brush strokes that you see in the ground. You know, randomize them and kind of tough them up so that it looks more like ground foliage as opposed to brush strokes. See all these little hairy bits that stick out on their own? By using this tufting brush, I help flesh out that space a little bit better, make it integrate a little bit more smoothly into the whole. Done for the day. I'm just basically playing with techniques here to see how stuff works. And then I come back to the very back layer here. Tap at that for a second, and then we'll call it quits. See, there you go. It flushes it out a little bit better. Change the angle here. Push at this. Change the angle again. We'll push over here. There you go. So we'll just call this quits for the day. So I'm going to hit save, and we'll pick this up on Monday. Thanks for playing, guys. We'll talk to you soon.